Hello, I'm Mike Watt, and once again, I'm talking to you from an empty room, and I am continuing my 15-part series on Exploitation Nation. And you can jump around. I'll label which ones are which. This was issue two. Issue one got a really, really good response. Issue one, our guide to lesbian vampire movies is still the top seller of the run. The number one was, go figure. Yes, it's a number one. Yes, it has sexy women in it. There's a tiny bit of nudity, if I recall, in there. So why wouldn't it be the bestseller? So we decided to keep going. So we took a poll among the writers and we came up with issue two, and it was all going to be about hunting cryptids. And this is artwork by Philip R. Rogers, who has been, I have gone to his well many, many times. Phil's an amazing artist. This was our cryptid issue. So this was our guide to Bigfoot and Mothman movies. And contributors again, Bill Adcock, Dr. Rhonda Bogman, Mike Householder, my friend Bill Hunter, Douglas Waltz, and William Wright. And again, cover artist by Philip Rogers. Amy Lynn Best, publisher, Carolyn Householder, assistant editor. It's nice we've been working together for so long that we have a consistent staff, and we have been since almost 2003, I think I've been able to go to these people. So this issue also contains my tribute to George Romero. This was his eulogy that I'd written for legacy.com. It's an obituary, and I was criticized online for not covering anything new. Well, Jesus Christ, guys, the man's dead. You know, so I didn't crawl into the coffin with him, pat him down for loose change. George was important to us. George was is important to all independent filmmakers and all fans of zombies, and it was important for us to acknowledge him. Although, you know, sticking him in the cryptid section, that was just an accident of timing. So we cover Boggy's Creek. We cover my friend Tom Bertinsky. He has a film called Sasquatch, and here you are. You can see Tom there with our good friend Pat Reese, the Bookbinder of the Dead. And here's more of Tom. Tom's great. Tom's been a longtime friend and a big supporter. And anyone who ventures into making independent films on their own will always have our blessing. Absolutely, we won't. I don't know if we'll turn you down. I mean, if you're making snuff porn with hamsters, I don't want to know. Well, I might want to know just so I know to stay away from you. Anyway. This reprint, again, so I had some content, it's completely incongruous because it's my uncut trip to the set of Sorority Row, where I got to mostly hang out with Gino Crognoli as he showed me one bizarre, wonderful effect after another, including the bottle down the girl's throat. Sorority Row is actually a pretty nifty remake, if you want to talk about it. Stuart Hendler did a pretty good job, and it was shot in my old film lab in WRS, where I spent many a days terrorized and gasping for air. So it was neat to see that transformed into that beautiful sorority house. So I got to talk to Rumor Willis and a bunch of other people, but mostly I hung out with Gino because effects artists rule. Williams at the cover of Boggy Creek. I will let the story run as long as we need to. I will edit for I don't edit for content. I will edit for space. And the writers have gotten to know that if they don't have the opportunity, they're not going to see the edits. At least I like to think so, that I'm gentle enough with it and I can mimic voice. I'm a good editor. Let's put it that way. So what else we got here? And then we have a nice review section. We didn't keep up with this so much with reviews on top of reviews because the magazine started to really reveal itself in issue three. The one thing that was consistent throughout and has been consistent in every single issue is Mike Householder's column, I'll buy that for a dollar, or I'd buy that for a dollar, and then which he goes into dollar bins of stores and shovels his wares into his shopping cart, goes home and tells us what was worth a buck or not. And I've always found that fun. Exploitation Nation, issue two, Hunting Cryptids. That's exploitation-nation.com if you want to pick it up. And leave us a review. Let us know what you think. And I will continue again with issue three.